So this week we're going to cover the respiratory and circulatory systems. And these two systems are going to work closely together. The circulatory system does some additional tasks for our body, but let's focus on how these two systems work together at first. They are going to help get oxygen to our cells and take carbon dioxide away from our cells. There are two parts to getting the body the oxygen that it needs. First, we have to get oxygen into the body. That's going to be the responsibility of the respiratory system. And then we need to distribute that oxygen to all the individual cells, and that's going to be the responsibility of the circulatory system. So just a quick reminder, why does the body need oxygen? If we have already talked about cellular respiration, this should be an easy answer. We need oxygen for cellular respiration to make ATP. Remember that oxygen is used in the mitochondria during the third step of cellular respiration called oxidative phosphorylation, and it's going to help pull electrons off of energy carrier molecules and help produce lots of ATP. We need ATP to power all the chemical reactions in the body, and thus getting oxygen into the body and to all the cells is going to be essential for life. One of the interesting things to think about is almost all of the materials our body needs, the raw materials to build parts or make energy, glucose, these are the kinds of things we can store, but we really can't store oxygen gas. And so instead we have to continually take it from the environment. Carbon dioxide is a waste of cellular respiration. It's the gas that is produced as a side product, primarily during the second step of cellular respiration, the Krebs cycle. And so as we make ATP using up oxygen, we're going to produce carbon dioxide. The circulatory system is going to take that away from our cells, and the respiratory system is going to help expel it out of our body.